Good afternoon, shooting fans, and welcome to Munich, Germany, here in the finals hall for the second final of the day, 25-meter rapid-fire pistol men. I'm Hilary Russell and have the pleasure once again of having India's team coach, Mohinder Lal, here with me today. Welcome, Mohinder, and thanks for joining me again this afternoon. It's always a pleasure to have you here with us.
Oh, thank you very much.
We've just finished up with the 25-meter pistol woman event and now going into this event. It's a little bit different. As far as the rules go, of course, everyone starts off with zero. And this is a hit-or-miss final where the men shoot at four series of five shots. After the fourth series, the athlete with the lowest score is eliminated. We then move forward, and the athlete with the lowest score is eliminated after every preceding series until we get our bronze, silver, and gold medalist. Just keep in mind, a 9.7 or higher is considered a hit. Once again, we have the elite who have come here that have been invited to Munich for this World Cup final. So we can see that we've got some incredible talent that's going into this today.
Yes, all the finalists are incredibly good shooters who have very good achievements to their credit. And some very young blood from People's Republic of China.
Exactly. And this is one that we're going to have to keep our eye on.
Yes.
Is Li Yuhong. He won the gold medal in Granada. He also won the silver in Shangwang, and he won the bronze in Fort Benning this year.
Yes.
So he's had an amazing, impressive year, and almost seems like he's untouchable.
Yes, he's very young.
Now, there was 10 athletes that went through qualifications today. Of course, only six made it in. A little bit different from 25-meter pistol woman, where there was nine out of eight that entered into the qualifications.
Yes, in rapid fire, we have only six finalists.
Exactly.
In other events, we have eight.
And here are our finalists today on firing point F, representing the United States of America. We have Emil Milev.
He's 45 years of age and started competing in the year 1984 when I went to represent in the Olympic Games in the USA from my country. And his current ranking is number 11.
Please welcome Emil Milev.
And he's a silver medalist from Atlanta.
Exactly. On firing point E, representing the People's Republic of China, we have Juan Fusheng.
He's 20 years of age and currently ranked 7 in the world, and he won a silver medal in the Munich World Cup.
On firing point D, representing Cuba, we have Lourdes Pupo.
He's 36 years of age, and his current world ranking is 2. And he won a gold medal in the London Olympics.
That is quite an impressive feat that he has done. On firing point C, representing the Czech Republic, we have Martin Strnad.
He's 39 years of age, and his current world ranking is 12. And he was a gold medal in the World Cup final in 2012.
On firing point B, everybody knows him, representing Germany, we have Christian Reitz.
Yes, he's 26 years of age and holds the current world record, and his ranking is number 1. He's from the factory of German shooters for rapid fire.
On firing point A, representing the People's Republic of China, we have Li Yuhong.
He's 24 years of age, and his current world ranking is 3. And he won a bronze medal in Munich in 2010.
Once again, it's not unusual that we have two gentlemen that have entered from the People's Republic of China.
Yes.
They do have an amazingly strong team, but we've got a lot of talent here. And we've got Christian Reitz, who represents Germany, and you know that the spectators here that are going to be rooting for him.
Yes.
So once again, we're going to be going through four series. After the fourth series, that's when the first person who is in sixth place is going to be eliminated.
Yes.
And this is really a fun final to watch because things can change at the very last minute.
Yeah, of course. Even till the last shot is fired, you are not sure what is going to happen.
That's right.
And this is probably one of the fastest events that is held in the Olympics.
That's right.
The whole match used to be fired in 72 seconds. And now in the final, it's slightly different. But the main match still remains the same. And the whole match is over in 72 seconds. You prepare years for that.
For that 72 seconds.
Yes. This is, of course, an elimination final, and the eliminations will
begin after the fourth series and continue after... Now, let's just talk about what do you usually see on the first series. Do you see perfect five out of fives, or are you more often used to seeing some misses in the first series?
With the caliber of the shooters that we have here, it is absolutely unpredictable what anyone is going to do. But I presume... It's slightly difficult to hit five out of five, though somebody will do it, even in the first series.
That's right.
But there'll not be many. There'll be, might be one.
And a five out of five is definitely the way to start off, without a doubt. If you can get as many points under your belt from the beginning, you're going to be able to have a little bit of time to, I wouldn't say relax, but just a little bit of that pressure.
Does any shot gathered gives you an advantage because they add up till the end.
Yes.
So whatever you get, if you reap it first, it adds to your confidence.
So we've got Lee starting off with two out of five hits.
Out of five.
Right. On now to Reitz. Once again, the pressure is on his shoulders. He's on his own home turf right now, and that can either work in your advantage or against you, depending on how you enjoy that pressure. Some people really need that. People in the stands be clapping for them, but also you can see that some of the athletes don't like to be on the home turf.
Yes. Generally, shooters would not have.
But Christian Reitz seems like it does work for him.
Reitz has started with a perfect fight.
Going on now to Strnad. Just waiting now for that green light. Green light means go.
Yes.
And four out of five is a very impressive way to start off as well.
Very good.
Let's move it on over now to the 2012 London Games gold medalist, Pupo. Wow, five out of five hits for Pupo.
That's a start like an Olympic champion.
That's right. On now to our second Chinese athlete, Juan. And three out of five for Chuang. And let's move it on over now to the United States of America's Milev.
Milev.
Mm-hmm.
attention.
You can see the red light's on, waiting now for the green.
Three hits
out of five. So let's take a look here. After our first series, we've got a tie now between Pupo and Reitz, who both started off excellently with five out of five hits. In third place, we have Strnad, who had four out of five hits. And tied up for fourth place, we have Milev and Zhuang with three out of five, and Lee finishing off now in sixth place with two out of five hits. We're still very, very early into this final.
Yes.
Things can change around. I'll tell you, the look in Pupo and Wright's eyes, they just had that look of gold shining in their eyes.
Yes.
We only have three more competition series remaining until we decide sixth place in the competition.
Now, Pupo has never made it into even a final round of a World Cup final before. He placed ninth last year. But in the meantime, let's just focus on Lee.
He's an Olympic champion. Maybe just after the Olympics, he did not take this year as a serious year for the shooting.
Mm-hmm.
He must have been just shooting, but not with a gusto to be stuck on. He's reserving his energies to come back into form for the next Olympics.
That's right. Three out of five hits for Li Yu Wong from the People's Republic of China. Moving it over now to Christian Reitz from Germany. Christian started off with a great five out of five. Let's see what the second series is going to have in store for him.
Yes.
Reitz. Attention.
Four hits.
Four out of five.
That really, a very,
really
very
excellent
score.
Okay, moving it on over now to Strnad.
Attention.
Here you see Strnad. Oftentimes see him in the finals.
Strnad,
yeah.
Again.
Good, great shooting, four out of five once again for Strnad.
After Reitz, he also gets four.
And on now to Pupo. He started off in perfect situation there with five out of five hits.
Yes.
Let's see how the second series goes for him.
Attention.
Two out of five. That's going to change things around on the scoreboard for Pupo.
Yes. It's a bit of a disappointment from five moving down to two.
Exactly. But like we were saying, and you were saying before, Mohinder, things can change around from series to series.
Yes, till the last shot is fired.
That's right. Again, on to the second gentleman from the People's Republic of China, Chuang Husheng.
Attention.
And that sounded just like it was going to be five out of five.
But shooting five out of five.
And let's see if Milev can follow right in his footsteps.
Milev.
Milev, who started off with three out of five.
Attention.
Three out of five, once again, for Milev.
Yes, three out of five. He still ranks fifth.
So let's take a look here. We've got Wright still holding on to first place. Now he's holding on by himself with 9 out of 10 hits.
Yes.
We've got a tie now, two-way tie for second place between Strnad and Duang with 8 out of 10. We have Poupeau, who's now moved down into fourth place. He has got 7 hits. Milev is in fifth place with 6, and Lee, 5. We still have 2 more series to go before the elimination process starts.
Yeah, after 2 series, elimination will start.
Yes.
We now have 2 series remaining until our first elimination. 6th place will be decided in 2 competition series.
I'm feeling quite confident about Reitz. I have a feeling that today could be his day.
It could be his day.
Okay, once again back on to Lee. Currently holding on to 6th place with 5 out of 10 hits. Three hits.
And his ranking is shown to be 6th.
Yes.
Which is not very comfortable.
That's not where you really want to be at this point, with only one more series to go before the elimination starts.
Yes.
Let's focus our attention now back on to Reitz.
Attention.
Four out of five for Reitz. He's shaking his head like he's not happy with that.
Yes.
You know, years ago, he used to have a totally different demeanor about him, that he could just shrug things off. But you can see that he's matured, and he's really taking things very seriously.
That he lost 1 point.
Right. Okay, back on now to Strnad.
Attention.
4 out of 5. He's shooting extremely strong, Strnad is. All right.
Strnad is also very much in the run.
Absolutely, he certainly is. There's only 1 hit behind Reitz.
Yes,
we've got
only
Poupeau.
1 hit behind Reitz.
Now he's coming off of 2 out of 5 hits. He started off with a perfect 5 out of 5.
Yes.
Let's see what this third series has in store for him.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's only 1 out of 5 hits. That is going to change his standings.
Yes.
There's his coach right now. He's looking a little bit bewildered. Okay, now back on to Juan. Juan is coming off of a perfect 5 out of 5.
Attention.
Well, it's not 5 out of 5 this time, it's 2 out of 5.
2 out of 5.
And moving it on over now to Milev.
Milev. Attention.
Nice. 4 out of 5 for Milev. So let's take a look. Things are getting very, very close here. We only have one more series to go before the elimination starts. We have Reitz still in first place. He's got a one-hit advantage over Strnad, who's right on his heels by 12. And we've got a two-way tie for third place between Milev and Zhuang. Li and Pupo have now tied up for fifth place with that one out of five hits for Pupo. That's been right down the leaderboard, and it's going to come down to this last series between these two men.
Let's see what to find he does out in the last series now.
Exactly.
Where the elimination will take place.
Keep your eye on that area of the leaderboard because the next series will decide.
So, yes, once again, after this series, it's going to determine who's in sixth place, and it's going to be a fight between Li and Pupo. And let's just focus in now on Li and see how this goes for him.
Attention.
Just waiting on that green light, and there it is. And three out of five.
Three out of five.
Three hits.
On to our number one contender at the moment, Christian Reitz from Germany. He's coming off of 2-4 out of fives. And both of those, he was not looking pleased at his score. But I have to say, 4 out of 5 is not a bad way to go.
No.
Attention.
Again, 4 out of 5 for Reitz. He's showing that he's very consistent in his shooting.
I'll tell you, the fans in the
stands are really liking his performance today.
Yes.
But let's take a look now at Strnad. He is really putting up a fight. He was only one point behind Reitz before, and we're just going to have to see how this goes, if he can keep the pressure on.
Yes.
You know, if he can do 5 out of 5, he'll be tied up for first place.
Yeah, yeah, of course.
Strnad. Attention.
Three out of five.
Three hits.
Okay, we're going back on now to Pupo. Pupo is going to need to have 4 out of 5 to overtake Li and stay in the runnings.
Three out of three
will keep him tied up, and then we'd go into an instant shoot-off after we finish the series.
He'll have to shoot a 5 out of 5. A perfect score.
No,
4 out of 5.
Yes.
Yep, 4 out of 5 to overtake Li.
Yes.
And there you go. That's the 4 out of 5 that keeps Pupo in the running. It keeps him in fifth place.
Yes.
On
so
now to
Li,
Chuan.
Probably Li will be the man.
Yes,
out.
Unless something drastically happens between Milev or Zhuang.
And Zhang.
Attention.
And that sounded very solid, and sure enough, it's 4 out of 5
four
hits.
4 out of 5 now. He's ranked third. And let's see now what Milev does.
Milev is coming off of 4 out of 5 hits.
Yes.
Milev. Attention.
Nice. Four out of five for Milev.
Four out of five.
So far, Milev has missed the first one every time. The first target. So let's take a look here. So what we've got here, we have got Li Yuhong from the People's Republic of China. We're going to have to say goodbye to him. He's been eliminated.
Yes.
Just missed it by one hit. Let's take a look here now.
Yes.
We've got Wright still holding on to first place by a two-hit advantage over Strnad. Milev has moved up the leaderboard and tied up now with Zhang with 14.
Yes.
And we have Pupo, two points behind.
Right. And one more series to go, and it will decide whether Pupo stays.
Exactly.
Yes.
So the pressure is really on Pupo right now.
Yes, yes.
Also being at a two-hit disadvantage.
Yes.
It's not undoable. There's no the chance that things could change around. And
oh,
something's going on here with Christian Reitz.
Yes.
Reitz, two hits.
Two out of five hits for Christian Reitz. That is a big surprise here. And this is exactly what Strnad needs to move up the leaderboard.
But he missed the first card. First target.
Strnad.
He'll get a penalty of 1 point.
Yes, he will.
Because he shot only four shots. I heard only four shots. I don't know why number one target is missing.
Attention.
Well, I couldn't, you know, we've got these headsets on, but it sounded like he had shot very fast and then waited a minute. So I'm not sure if he was off the timing or what happened there.
But he has adequate lead to take care of this.
Strnad,
if he doesn't even ask for a malfunction, it's okay for him.
Well, Strnad.
He's adequate lead. He's 19 points. And the nearest rival is at 14.
Pupo.
Okay, this is up to Pupo now.
Yes.
He's two hits in the disadvantage.
Yes.
Attention.
Four out of five. That's
four
a very, very nice comeback for Pupo.
Yes. Let's see. Where does he land now?
Well, currently he's still
Pupo
holding on to fifth place. It's going to take something drastic by Zhuang or Milev.
Oh.
Attention.
Just waiting on that green light now for Zhuang. And there it is. Fantastic. Five out of five hits for Zhuang.
Oh, he has moved up.
He has moved up. He's
and
tied
he's
up now.
Now tied up.
Tied up with Reitz.
With Reitz.
Milev.
Okay, on now to Milev. Milev coming off of four out of five.
Yes.
Let's see if we can boost that up to five out of five and put us in a three-way tie. Let's see how this goes for Milev.
Oh.
And there you go.
Five out of five.
Excellent shooting. That ties him up. A three-way tie now.
Yes. He comes to number one.
That's right. He's moved up to the number one. We are going to have to say goodbye to
tough competition for the medals.
Absolutely. In fifth place, we have representing Cuba, Luis Pupo.
The Olympic champion moves out.
Moving out into fifth place. We now have a three-way tie for first place between Reitz, Milev, and Huang. Strnad is now down into fourth place. He is two hits
behind. But we never know what will happen because after this series, Strnad is also only 2 points behind some mishap, like the one happened to Reitz.
Exactly.
It can upset the whole apple cart. Let's see what happens now.
I like some of your terminology. You have to pull up your socks and it can upset the whole apple cart. Okay, the pressure now is on Reitz. He knows where he's standing. He's heard the scores. He is now tied up 19 to 19 to 19. Milev, Reitz, and Fuang.
Three hits out of five.
Mohinder's getting nervous here, just to let you all know. Anyone who's listening to this right now, you can tell that Mohinder, you're getting a little bit nervous.
yeah, of course. I'm feeling into the game.
Yes, absolutely. Okay, Strnad, who's got a two-hit disadvantage at the beginning of this series. Let's see how this last series goes for him.
Attention.
Unbelievable. Fantastic. Five out of five hits for Strnad. That's how you come back and make your name known, without a doubt. Okay, on to Juan.
Attention.
All right, he needs just three to tie up and four or five to get right up there in the lead once again.
Three
is going to tie him up. We are going to have ourselves a shoot-off to find out who's going to be going home with the bronze, without a doubt.
Yes, after Milev completes his series, then we'll have to see who will go out.
And it's going to take a shoot-off to find out who's going to be going out.
Yes.
Okay, on now to Milev. Again, three to tie, four to go in advance, five to put the distance between himself and the others.
Yes.
Unbelievable. Again, five out of five from Milev.
Excellent shooting.
Strnad
and Milev, both have shot 5 out of 5.
Who would have thought? That is really, really fantastic.
There's a shoot-off now.
Yes, there's going to be a three-way shoot-off to find out who's going to be going home in fourth place.
Yes.
And that's going to be between Reitz, Strnad, and Zhuang. Milev now is holding on to first place by himself. He's got a two-hit advantage over the others.
Yes.
Attention.
Now, this is going to also give Milev some time by himself, not having to shoot, get out of the routine. How do you think that's going to affect his next series?
Could you repeat the question?
Of course. Now, I'm saying that Milev now is not going to be shooting because of this. The shoot-off is taking place. So he's got some time.
Yes.
How do you think that's going to affect his next series?
I think he'll have more time to concentrate.
Okay.
I think that'll not affect him much.
Okay.
It'll be a positive interlude for him because others will be shooting. He'll just be concentrating.
Excellent. Okay, so what did we have there? We had three out of five for Reitz. Moving on now to Strnad.
Because it's the only one series that will matter now.
Exactly.
Somebody will go out.
Exactly. And
Strnad is also there.
Three out of five also. So
yes.
We could keep on going forward with this shoot-off,
yes,
but let's just
of
see
course.
What...
Now Zhang will have to shoot more to...
Yes, to stay
be
in.
Be comfortable in the competition, otherwise there'll be shoot-off again for him too.
Attention.
suspension.
Just waiting on that green light, and there it is. Again, three out of five. We're going to keep on
three
going
out of five.
Forward.
All three of them shoot again. The tie will have to be broken.
That's right. Milev is still going to have to hold off and wait.
Yes.
Right.
Okay, again, back on to Reitz. He may have thought that he had lost his opportunity, but he certainly did not.
Attention.
There you go, five out of five, and the crowd is loving it.
Yes.
This is the way, way you save yourself.
He's not the one who's going out, because
no.
There are two others to shoot.
That's right. But you never know. You could see two other five
others,
out of fives.
Yeah, the others could also do the same thing.
Five for Strnad.
Yes.
That could keep him in the game, but we're just going to have to find out what Zhuang has up his sleeve.
Yes.
He needs four out of five to stay in the contention.
Yes.
And there you go. He's done it. Four out of five.
At least Reitz.
Reitz has sealed.
Safe.
Yes,
now,
he's saved
there'll
himself.
Be another tie shoot between Strnad and Zhang.
Mm-hmm. So we do have two places that are secure right now. Milev
yes.
with 24 hits. We have
yes.
Reitz with 22.
Two and
Strnad.
And now we're going to wait for Strnad
and Zhang.
Let's
see now who goes out.
Yes.
Attention.
Whoa, five out of five for Strnad. Unbelievable.
Strnad has thrown a big challenge to Zhang.
Yes,
now.
He has. Nothing is impossible, but at
but he can also do it.
That's right, but this is a very big challenge. This is riding on going home with a medal or not going home with a medal.
Yes,
so the pressure
this
is twofold here for Zhuang.
Attention.
That's too bad. Three out of five is not going to do it. We're going to have to say goodbye to Zhuang.
Yes.
Finishing up
taking
in fifth place,
in
fourth place, excuse me.
Representing the People's Republic of China, Zhang Fusheng.
Zhang Fusheng, finishing up. Yes, the youngest shooter today.
The youngest shooter in the finals, 20 years of age.
That's right. Okay, so Mohinder, we're going for the bronze now.
Yes, now.
And we've got Milev, who is still 2-hit advantage over the others, but we've just seen that you just never know what's going to happen.
You're absolutely right. You do not really know what will happen now.
That's right.
First position with a 2-hit advantage. The next series will decide bronze medal in this competition.
All right, we're going for the bronze right now between Reitz, Strnad, and Milev. And that is three out of five for Reitz.
Yes.
Three out of five to tie up. Four out of five to stay in the contention for the silver and gold for Strnad.
Strnad.
Okay, just waiting on the green light for Strnad now. And also three out of five. You know, we were saying this is the fastest final so far. This is turning into one of the longest finals so far, Mohinder. Okay, again now onto Milev. He's had a little bit of a break here during these shoot-offs. He does have a two-hit advantage over the others.
Yes.
You know, he's coming off of two perfect 5 out of 5 hits. Let's see if he can do it again. Nice. Four out of five for Milev.
He
is really showing
now
his strength.
Now he's taking a three-point lead over his rivals. And now there'll be shoot-off for the bronze medal.
Shoot-offs, shoot-offs, and shoot-offs. That's what it's all about today.
Yes.
Okay, back on now to Reitz. It's so hard to even make an assumption of who could win this. Five out of five for Christian Reitz. He always has something up his sleeve.
Yes.
Really amazing, amazing shooting. Okay, on now to Strnad. That's really puts the pressure on him wholeheartedly. He has got to get 5 out of 5 to stay tied up. There's no chance he can overtake Reitz at the moment, but there is a chance that Reitz can overtake him.
There is a chance.
Mm-hmm.
The last series, you don't know. One never knows what will happen.
Unbelievable.
Oh,
5 out of 5.
That's a fantastic shooting.
Even he is shaking his head.
Shoot-off.
Yes.
Shooting 5 out of 5.
Unbelievable.
That's really fantastic.
Once again, Emil has got some time here just to get ready for this last series that he'll be shooting. He's got a 3-hit advantage over the others, and the others are just going neck to neck. I don't even think that Christian Reitz probably saw that coming with Strnad coming off with the 5 out of 5.
Yes.
He probably had thought that he had secured himself to not go home with the bronze, but let's just see how this next series goes for Reitz.
Three out of five.
Okay, it's now on to Strnad's shoulders.
Strnad.
3 out of 5 to tie up once again with Reitz, or 4 out of 5, or 5 out of 5 to overtake him. Again, 3 out of 5.
three out of 5.
Even with other jury members shaking their heads, saying, you got to be kidding me. Even Christian Reitz, he's got a smile on his face. It does get to be a bit humorous after a while when you just keep on thinking someone's going to be overtaking the other. And at the very last second, everything just ends up being the way that it was before.
Three hits.
Three out of five for Reitz. He cannot be shaking his head. You never know what's going to happen. Once again,
Reitz is not happy that
no.
he has only three hits.
Once again, Strnad. We've got Strnad.
Let's
not
see.
Quite sure what he's got up his sleeve this time. He needs three again to tie up, four or five to overtake Reitz.
Attention.
And there you go. That does it. Four out of five for Strnad. We'll keep him in the game. Let's see if we can take a look at our bronze medalist right now. Sure enough.
Reitz,
Christian Reitz. Yes, he does.
She gets the bronze.
There he is, our bronze medalist representing Germany. We have Christian Reitz. Look at him, he's just shaking his head, saying, how could this have gone on for so long? All right, so let's get back into this again. We've got Milev and Strnad going at it. We've got Milev with a three-hit advantage over Strnad. You know, you'd say that's plenty, that's enough, but this never enough.
Never enough, yes.
And you can be rest assured that probably Strnad is probably quite tired right now. He's been shooting a whole lot more than Milev has with all these shoot-offs that he's been in.
Three hits.
Three out of...
Three hits.
Okay. All we have to do is that Milev has got to shoot just one target.
Even if he doesn't get one, then there's a tie.
Exactly, exactly. But I have a feeling that he's got it
well,
in him.
He's
got it in.
Well,
if he finishes it off with a 5 out of 5, that would just be amazing, amazing shooting. Let's see how this goes for Emil Miller from the United States of America.
Attention.
There you go. He's won it.
Oh.
And finishing off with 5 out of 5.
Emil wins it with style.
For Milev. Unbelievable shooting. That is
5 out of 5. Excellent show.
That is really beautiful, beautiful shooting. There is our gold medalist who represented the United States of America, Emil Milev. Fantastic shooting. He just climbed up the scoreboard and nailed the gold.
Yes.
And our silver medalist of the day today, Czech from the Czech Republic, Martin Strnad. Excellent shooting also from him. And of course, our bronze medalist, Christian Reitz from Germany. Mohinder, thank you again for joining me today. It's been so nice to have you here. And I wish you the best of relaxation for the month or so before you get back into it.
Oh, thank you very much.
25-meter rapid-fire pistol men's event will now take place. Will you please welcome your medalists? The medals will be presented by Mr. Gary Anderson, Vice President of the ISSF. He is accompanied by Mr. Franz Schreiber, the Secretary General of the ISSF. Your bronze medalist, representing Germany, Christian Reitz. Your silver medalist, representing the Czech Republic, Martin Strnad. And your gold medalist, representing the United States of America, Emil, Milev. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the national anthem of the United States of America.